Hi, I'm Jimmy. Cheeseburger in paradise. But then I think about the good time down in the Caribbean sunshine. I don't know.
Up on the hill.
I don't know.
Down in the front.
There's to the left. There's to the right. You're the only baby.
Over the years, after surviving rock and roll this long, you tend to acquire a few things. Collections of guitars, set lists, picks, ex-band members, whatever have you. We also have an interesting collection of videos because way back when I accidentally plunged into the world of video before it was even called video. I guarantee you that you will meet some interesting characters in these videos. You'll see some interesting places. So without any further ado, through the magic of Margarita Vision, let's take a look.
For my lost shaker salt. Some people claim that there's a woman to blame. Always is in an old, it's my own damn fault.
Like everything else involved in this career, there is no master plan. Video certainly was no exception. In about 1973, I got a call from a gentleman named Rick Trow, who had been contracted by ABC Records to come make a film on me. He didn't know me, I didn't know him, we didn't know what we were going to do. They arrived, the writer got drunk, I had to write the thing in 45 minutes. So under circumstances like that, I called on my friends, who immediately came to my aid. I went to the bars where we actually drank, and what we actually came up with in retrospect is probably an incredible history of Key West in the 70s, the people and the places. Key West has been and always will be a town in the middle of the hurricane center, and you never know who's going to blow through.
Buffett? Jimmy Buffett? I can't say I've ever heard of him.
Excuse me, we're looking for a guy named Jimmy Buffett.
The name sounds familiar, but I can't place the face. What are you guys doing? Making a film? You're from Hollywood or something?
You know someone around here by the name of Buffett?
Sure, I know him. Hell of a nice guy. Shouldn't have any trouble finding him. Key West is not all that big of an island.
Jimmy Buffett? Sure, I know him. This is his vehicle. Lives right up the street there. Probably be in by now.
Are you the film crew? I guess I can let you in, being as he's expecting you.
Oh, film crew, right. It's today. I was just getting up.
Be a little crazy to live on now, especially this one. But my kind of work being a little bit crazy helps. Freaks, straights, winos, it doesn't matter. And everybody here is a part of what I do. I guess we're all here for about the same thing. Whatever that is.
You know, sometimes I feel really guilty about getting paid as much as I do for what I do. But it's all still a lot of fun. But when it stops being a lot of fun, I'll just quit.
Pencil Thin Mustache was the first video that we recorded. I called my friends who appear in this collage. Some are still living, some are still in jail, some are dead, some have vanished. I'm still here doing the video. We took a walk from the shores of the Gulf of Mexico south to the shores of the Atlantic Ocean. About a mile and a half. Took us about a day, but in the process we covered Duval Street the way you won't see it today. So as the song says, let's take a look at the way it used to be. Pencil thin mustache.
Now they make new movies in old black and white, with a happy endings where nobody fights. So if you find yourself in that nostalgic rage, honey, jump right up and show your age. I wish I had a pencil thin mustache, the Boston blackie kind, two-tone Ricky Ricardo jacket and an autographed picture of Andy Devine. I remember being buck-toothed and skinny, writing fan letters to Sky's niece Penny. Oh, I wish I had a pencil thin mustache, then I could solve some mysteries too. Then it's bandstand, Disneyland, growing up fast, drinking on a fake ID.
Monday. Thank you very much. One of my 2.4 hit records. We had no money to do this video. Thus, I had my girlfriend at the time, Jane, work for free. She had been modeling. She now is my wife. She doesn't work for free anymore. The car is not a prop. That was my truck and my Conk Cruiser until it was impounded and crushed into a scrap metal rectangle at Carlos's junkyard. The Boston Whaler was my first boat that I ever bought. There really wasn't much need in scripting this. This was where I lived, the people I lived with, and the girl who I wrote Come Monday about. So here it is.
Heading up to San Francisco for the Labor Day weekend show. I got my hush puppies on. I guess I never was meant for glitter rock and roll. And honey, I didn't know that I'd be missing you so. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side. Yes, it's been quite a summer, rent-a-cars and westbound trains. And now you're off on vacation, something you tried to explain. And darling, it's I look so, that's the reason I just let you go. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side. I can't help it, honey, you're that much a part of me now. Remember that night in Montana when we said there'd be no room for doubt. I hope you're enjoying the scenery. I know that it's pretty up there. We can go hiking on Tuesday. With you I'd walk anywhere. California has worn me quite thin. I just can't wait to see you again. Come Monday, it'll be alright. Come Monday, I'll be holding you tight. I spent four lonely days in a brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side. I spent four lonely days in a brown L.A. haze, and I just want you back by my side.
To me, the great thing about filming He Went to Paris was I didn't have to be there. It was shot in Philadelphia in a shipyard in February, not a location I was really interested in going to. The song itself is inspired by an old Spanish Civil War veteran named Eddie Balchowski, who worked at The Quiet Night in Chicago, where I played in the early days. He was an artist, a painter, had lost an arm in the war and was a great influence on me, and I find myself being influenced by a lot of older people. Hopefully I'll grow into one of these days. So for all those people who cherish this song as much as I still do, here's He Went to Paris.
He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so. He was impressive, young and aggressive, saving the world on his own. But the warm summer breezes, the French wines and cheeses put his ambition at bay. Summers and winters scattered like splinters, and 4 or 5 years slipped away. He went to England, played the piano, and married an actress named Kim. They had a fine life, she was a good wife, and bore him a young son named Jim. And all of the answers and all of the questions locked in his attic one day. As he liked quiet, clean country living, and 20 more years slipped away. Well, the war took his baby. Bombs killed his lady and left him with only one eye. His body was battered, his whole world was shattered, and all he could do was just cry. While the tears were falling, he was recalling answers he never found. So he hopped on a freighter, skidded the ocean, and left England without a sound. Now he lives in the islands, fishes the pilings, drinks his green label each day. writing his memoirs, losing his hearing, but he don't care what most people say. Through 86 years of perpetual motion, if he likes you, he'll smile and he'll say, Jimmy, some of it's magic, some of it's tragic, but I had a good life all the way. He went to Paris looking for answers to questions that bothered him so.
I love looking at this piece of footage because as the camera scans the crowd here, it truly shows the wonderful different personalities and people that made up Key West before it became the tourist destination that it is today. It was shot in the Lantern Inn on Stock Island. That's now a Mexican restaurant if you'd like to visit there. The song Nautical Wheelers has always been one of my favorites. It was the square dancing group in Key West who used to dance under surplus parachutes in the city hall. And I still get a big kick out of playing Nautical Wheelers every time I can.
We're going to finish out here and do a song entitled Nautical Wheelers, which is written about a square dance group here in Key West and a sailboat expedition. We had a little regatta, and my friend Phil Clark was tied to the Southeast Channel marker real drunk, and we had to go out and bail him in, so I never won the race, but it made a good song anyway, and it's entitled Nautical Wheelers.
Nautical wheelers who call themselves sailors play fiddle tunes under the stars and petticoats rustle and working shoes scuffle, then shuffle on down to the bar where the jukebox is blasting and the liquor is flowing and occasional bottle of wine. That's cause everyone here is just more than content to be living and dying in a three-quarter time. And just dance with me, Nautical Wheelers. Take me to the stars that you know. Come on and dance with me, Nautical Wheelers. I want cause everyone here is just more than content to be living and dying.
Sure, I know. In fact, you might say it's responsible for my condition this morning.
Cut to 1983. We've left Key West for Hollywood. Well, actually San Pedro, dressed up to look like Tahiti. Our model now is a former Playboy centerfold. The vehicle is a Cadillac Eldorado convertible. And Joe Namath stops by for a cameo as a Hawaiian shirt salesman. Best of all, we're being directed by Michael Nesmith, former monkey but innovator of video, which has now come alive. We're on our way. Well, maybe. Today, still, I haven't made it on MTV, but we were headed in the right direction.
He took one last look,
wound up in Tahiti by way of Hawaii, and a friend of mine who was a promoter there doing shows had connections in Tahiti, and somehow or another I convinced him to book me in Papeete, where I knew no one and had no fans. But that's what life's about, is going out there on the cutting edge and seeing what's on the other side. So when we got there, lo and behold, what's going on? They're shooting the movie of Mutiny on the Bounty with Mel Gibson and Anthony Hopkins. And somehow or another, we convinced the assistant to the assistant prop manager, after buying him several shots of tequila, to let us use the boat, Mel Gibson's uniform, and a cast of dancing girls the next morning to shoot our video. I didn't even have a video in mind when we did this, but I knew that I didn't want to let this opportunity pass me by without documenting it. So a few years later, somebody wanted a video, and sure enough, I contacted my old friend Frank Martin. He found the video, put it together. We scrambled up a storyboard and again went back to Key West to make the connection between the Caribbean and French Polynesia, which was my original musical intention, to combine steel drums with Tahitian choirs. And Frank did the video. Margot Hemingway appears in Key West, drops into this on the way to another video location, which is an entire other story. But that's what happens when you go looking for those exotic places. You might just wind up finding that one particular harbor. I know where mine is. I'm sure you know where yours are too.
Younger days, I was so bad, laughing about all the fun we had. the world spins. Mixing different oceans, beating cousins. Listen to the drummers and the night sound. Listen to the singers make the world go.
La Vie d'Ensemble is French for the dancing life. Again, as a video, I went back to my old friend Michael Nesmith, and we did this as a part of a television show that he had on NBC. I think on the first week that it played, maybe 3 people watched it. So there hasn't been a large segment of the population that has actually seen this video. For all you computer and video geeks out there, this was before the days of high-tech computers, and though we thought we were on the cutting edge, when you look at it now, maybe we weren't. But it was an attempt at doing some interesting things with some footwork by the memorable Bunny Briggs on tap and the twisted mind of Michael Nesmith, and I'd have to throw myself into that mix too. So here's The Dancing Life, La Vie d'Ensemble.
Magic of movies, huh? A rag, a bone, some tape that's sticky on both sides. You got Moonrise over St. Bart's, the Caribbean home of Jimmy Buffett. That's Buffett with 2 T's. 1 T, that's buffet, that's lunch. And Jimmy's song, La Vie d'Ensemble, which we made a little movie of. La Vie d'Ensemble, that's French for, it's Cajun for the dancing life. And if you look real close, you'll see Bunny Briggs, the world's greatest performing tap dancer. And that's it, Ward, you can start the playback.
James, time to awaken.
Take it all away. Break your heart by the light of day. Drown your love in a distant bay so lonely. See the ships heading for the rocks. See the time melting off of the clocks. There's the light shatters all the locks and saves me. It saves me. That's why I wonder.
Feel it all with a willing heart. Every stop is a place to start. If you know how to play the part with feeling, I play with feelings. That's why I wander and follow La Vie d'Ensemble.
On the
back to Key West for this one. Once again, calling on friends to bail me out of low budgets and tight schedules. Rick Bennett is directing this video. He was my roommate in college and the bass player in my original band, the Upstairs Alliance. Jane Buffett makes an appearance this time, not as the girlfriend model, but as the ex-girlfriend, ex-model, aspiring actress. I gave her the job hoping I could get her back. I don't know if that's why she came back or not. Key West once again was the location. Will Jennings again was the writer on the song, and he also had thespian interest and plays the part of the wayward cowboy in this film. My only complaint with this is sometimes Will is mistaken for me, and I find that highly offensive. So I hope that you can figure out who's Jimmy and who's Will and who's the blonde stranger.
Hi, partners, welcome to the Seahawks capital of the world. It's 92 of the shades. So shift your duds and ropes like spuds, jerks, beware, there's something right there.
Nothing like this way out in West Texas. Galveston Bay is a whole other world. My wife's in our room getting over her sunburn. How would Louis L'Amour get me next to that girl? She tells me her tan is the same way all over. She asks me to dance and says, keep your boots on. She never met a number one cowboy. We rolled in the sand and drank rum until dawn.
Who's the blonde stranger who entered my life? Making me over in the moonlight. This side of Texas is all new to me. Who's the blonde stranger who lives by the sea?
Stayed up all night, and for me that's the first time. In the room just as cool as I can. Pull back the sheets and the bed is all empty, except for a note left from some guy named Dan. My head got all light and the room started spinning. I stepped outside just to get some fresh air. Out on a wave was my own darling Lola and some pretty boy with bleach in his hair.
The blonde stranger out there with my wife. What were they doing in the moonlight? This side of Texas is all new to me. Who are these strangers who live by the sea?
Back on the ranch and everything's normal. Beach blanket bingo comes on the TV. We talk in our sleep and then the next morning I ask her who's Dan and she says, who's Marie?
Who's the blonde stranger who entered my life? Making me over.
Hey, I know. We've made 7 videos. Nobody's played us yet. Let's don't put any of our relatives in it. Let's spend a lot of money. Let's go to Hollywood and get a big-time MTV director, and sure, they'll put us on television. Well, we did all of that, threw in a couple of cameos by Hollywood movie stars, stayed up all night like we were supposed to, shot the video, and guess what? Nobody's ever seen it. So it goes in the magic world of show business. But now you get to see homemade music. Story actually came as an inspiration for a short story with a character named Tully Mars and a story called Take Another Road. After that, I wrote the song, and our excuse for doing this video in Key West was that it was one of the few places left that actually had a drive-in theater where we wanted to shoot. And then we got down there, and once we had the drive-in, then we ran into the great problem of where are we going to find a horse that would allow us to take him on a shrimp boat. Somehow or another, we were able to come up with a solution to that production problem. This was the first of several videos that I did with my old friend and still photographer turned video director, Jim Shea. And we had always had kind of a great working relationship in which we were able to pull off some interesting situations against some pretty interesting odds. Let's see, anybody in here? No, there's no famous people in this video. just the horse, but he should be famous enough. Outstanding Academy Award role. Spot. Jamaica Farewell has been a favorite song of mine for as long as I can remember. I have been a Harry Belafonte fan for that long as well. And I consider it a privilege to record this song. I've been accused of being a person that likes to work fast, whether it's with recording or other things. And again, I called on Jim Shea, who I knew could follow me at my pace. And we recorded this song at a Great Woods concert outside of Boston. The thing I like about this video is I'm watching the chronological aging of my daughter. Savannah popped popped into view in the first video of one particular harbor as a toddler in the conga line, and now she appears as a budding teenager and, God forbid, a future background singer. So take a look at Jamaica Farewell.
I'd like to take you back to the beginnings when I first heard this song. This is what got me out of Mobile, Alabama. Thank you, Harry Belafonte. I hope you like what we've done to your song. Here we go. I took a trip on a sailing ship, but when I reached Jamaica, I made her stop. Now I'm sad to say, I'm on my way.
On my way.
I won't be back for many a day.
My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
Sounds and laughter everywhere, and the dancing girls sway to and fro. I must declare my heart is there, though I have been from Maine to Mexico. Still I'm sad to say I'm on my way.
On my way.
I won't be back for many a day.
My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
Yeah, Robert G. You can hear ladies cry out while on their heads they bear. Aki rice, salt fish or nice. Oh, the rum is fine any time of the year. Now I'm sad to say I'm on my way.
On my way.
I won't be back for many a day.
My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
Down the way where the nights are gay and the sun shines daily on the mountain top. I took a trip on a sailing ship, but when I reached Jamaica, I made her stop. Now I'm sad to say I'm on my way.
On my way.
I won't be back for many a day.
My heart is down, my head is turning around. I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
I had to leave a little girl in Kingston town.
On my way, Harry! Holy cow!
I guess all good things must come to an end, and my fascination with the video came to an end about the point that I was being asked to do another video by the record company. They just had to have this to break this record. By then it was apparent to me that I wasn't going to break too many more records, no matter how many videos I made. Plus, I'd spent quite a bit of time, as they say in the business, sitting around watching paint dry on movie and video sets. So, as much as they insisted that they had to have the video, I insisted that we had to do it my way, and that meant just shooting us while we were in rehearsal. What came out of the video of Another Saturday Night was an inside look at a band working hard behind the curtain. to make what comes out in front of the curtain look easy. Style. 1994 was the last pre-produced video that we ever did, Fruitcakes. They talked me into it after another Saturday night. But I had Jim Shea back, big production on the lot at Universal in Florida. And the fun thing about this one that we went out on was involving the fans. We had a casting call for Parrot Heads, and they did show up. It has been an interesting observation point to look at the fan base that started from maybe 20 people in a coffee house to 20,000 people in venues all across the country, for which I am eternally grateful. But I never could figure out how they got so deeply into this that they would abandon their lives and dress up like anything from sharks to parrots to hula dancers to express their appreciation of this music. So I thought it would be nice to involve and let them see the magic of the camera. And after 18 hours in the scorching Florida sun in Orlando, the magic kind of wore off. And it was a perfect group of people, including the Junkanoos from the Bahamas to the Parrothead clubs from across Florida came. And when it was all over, everybody went away with a smile on their face. It was a great experience to watch them. It was a great experience to work with them. And at the end of the day, one thing is for certain, we're all fruitcakes on this bus.
Fruitcakes, talking to my friend Desdemona. The other day, she runs the space station and bake shop down near Boomtown. She told me that human beings are flawed individuals. That the cosmic bakers took us out of the oven a little too early. And that's the reason we're as crazy as we are. And I believe it. Fruitcakes in the kitchen.
Fruitcakes in the kitchen.
Fruitcakes on the street. Strutting naked through the crosswalk in the middle of the week. Half-baked cookies in the oven. Half-baked people on the bus. There's a little bit of fruitcake left in every one of us. Paradise, lost and found. Paradise, take a look around. I was out in California where I hear they have it all. Riots, fires, and mudslides. They got sushi in the mall. Water bars, brontosaurs, Chinese modern lust. Shake and bake life with the quick. The secret's in the crust. Fruitcakes in the kitchen.
Fruitcakes in the kitchen.
Fruitcakes on the street. Strut naked through the crosswalk in the middle of the week. Half-baked cookies in the oven. Half-baked people on the bus. There's a little bit of fruitcake left in every one of us. Religion, religion. Oh, there's a thin line between Saturday night and Sunday morning. Here we go now. All right, altar boys. Mea Koopa, Mea Koopa, Mea Maxima Koopa. Mea Koopa, Mea Koopa, Mea Maxima Koopa. Where's the church? Who took the steeple? Religion's in the hands of some crazy-ass people. Television preachers with bad hair and dimples. The God's honest truth is it's not that simple. It's the Buddhist in you. It's the pagan in me. It's the Muslim in him. She's Catholic, ain't she? It's that born-again look. It's the wasp in the Jew. Tell me what's going on. I ain't got a clue. Relationships, we all got them, we all want them. What do we do with them? Here we go, I'll tell you. She said you've got to do your fair share. Now cough up half the rent. I treat my body like a temple. You treat yours like a tent. But the right word at the right time. Hey, give me a little hug. That's the difference between lightning and a harmless lightning bug. Oh! Fruitcakes in the kitchen. Fruitcakes on the street. Strutting naked through the crosswalk in the middle of the week. Half-baked cookies in the oven. Half-baked people on the bus. There's a little bit of fruitcake left in every one of us. Crumbs are spread all around this universe. I've seen fruitcakes. I saw this guy in Santa Monica roller skate naked through the crosswalk. Down in New Orleans, in the French market, they have fruitcakes like you cannot believe. New York, forget it. Fruitcake City. Down Island, we got fruitcakes. Spread them crumbs around. That's right. We want them around. Keep baking, baby. Keep baking.
These last couple of videos that are included in this collection come to you from the road. Parrot head. as I said, came about from watching the parrot heads and fruitcakes, and we have evolved into doing a part of the show and taking a couple of songs in which we feature the video of the audience as opposed to the video of the performer. People ask me a lot, don't I ever get tired of doing all these songs over and over again? And I say no, because what keeps everything fresh to me is looking at the audience's reaction and how they actually come to the shows and how they participate in our shows. So I thought it would be nice to let the audience see what they look like from our viewpoint. So every night we're on tour, Changes in Latitudes has become kind of the Parrotheads video anthem. And I can honestly say that I think that we still are kind of all crazy in this business, and if we weren't all crazy, we would go insane. And this is what they look like to us.
To recall the whole year, all of the faces, all of the places, wonder where they all disappeared. I didn't ponder the question too long. I was hungry and went out for a bite. Ran into a chum with a bottle of rum, and we wound up drinking all night. It's these changes in latitude, changes in attitude. Nothing remains quite the same. Through all of our running and all of our cutting, if we could laugh, we would all go insane. Reading departure signs in some big airport reminds me of the places I've been. Visions of good time brought so much pleasure, make me want to go back again. If it suddenly ended tomorrow, getting close, I could somehow adjust to the fall. Help me, help me! Good times and riches and see more than I can recall. With my changes in attitude, changes in attitude, nothing remains quite the same. Through all of the islands and all of the highlands, if we could laugh, we would all go insane. Wish I could jump on a plane. So many nights I sit and dream of the ocean. I wish I was sailing again. Yesterday's over my shoulder, I can't look back for too long. Too much to see waiting in front of me, and I don't think I can go wrong. With these changes in latitude, changes in attitude, nothing remains quite the same. Through all of our running and all of our cunning, if we could laugh, we would all go insane. If we could laugh, we would all go insane. If we were not crazy, we would go.
I love being able to get out and ride my bicycle that I carry on the road all around the cities and the towns that we visit. We have put together what we hope is a tribute to all the cities and the places and the people that are our hosts as we visit and go on tour every year. So here is the city written by Mac McAnally, and here are the cities and the people who we see every year.
Ah, 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 ah Say, child, on the farm I was warned of the wiles of the city, of that demon disguised as the dirt in the skies of the city. Well, they say the proximity warps their minds till they shoot one another just to pass the time. And we live, it appears, both in spite and in fear of the city. Constantly told how our lives were controlled by the city, how they keep us in debt with the trance that they said is a pity, how the beautiful people in the magazines got the normal ones living beyond their means, and the things that they said made me grow in my head to the city. Still the same in the city. You're still under the thumb of the rich and the young and the pretty. Well, they weren't much different than we might act if there was that many of us that closely packed. It's an ancient idea, but it struck me so clear in the city.
That's it. More videos than I ever dreamt that I would ever do. Now all put into a collection, and guess what? I have been tricked into doing another video. 1973 to the turn of the century. I guess I'll have to say it again. This will be the last video I'll ever do, but I'll probably do another one. And summing it all up, I guess I just have to say it's been a lovely cruise. I hope you enjoyed it, and we'll see you on the next video location.
Drink it up. This one's for you. It's been a sorry it's ended, oh it's sad, but it's true, honey, it's been a lovely cruise. These moments you left with, may you always remember.
This was the sensitive artist. Oh, I had bubbles on my lips. Mm.
God damn it, I was close.
So I wound up writing the... damn it. Whiting. I thought I put it that. With whiting to see what you... I don't want to do that again. There's something I left out. Well, what are we doing? What am I doing? Let me do that again.
Great, that's great.
Wow. It's hard to relive my life.
Marker.
It takes a lot longer to explain it. There's an ant biting my foot as this fucking fly goes up my arm. I'm gonna wait because if I let this crew have any film left, they're gonna make me do this again. How much film you got left?
Almost none.
Okay, good. 25 years of video, more than I'd ever want to look at or see. Did I already say it's been a lovely cruise? Shit, that's it. I'm done. Y'all are the editors. You'll find a good one.